quite a long time, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Wow, we are so sorry for that whole month and a half, maybe 2 month hiatus, folks.
School for me, work for Mike.
And vacation.
Also, I know I said it in the description for the last video, but I apologize for Mike's commentary in the last part where he was like...
sleeping.
So tired. No, you weren't sleeping, but you were so tired that you were just questioning the existential. In any event, welcome to one of my least favorite missions, even in this new version.
See what I mean? Oh. What the fuck?
See?
Don't go after the gems yet, what are you, fool? Don't you get a skill point for getting all the crabs here or not?
I don't know if it's crabs or not, but I'm failing hard.
You wanna retry?
Yes. Actually, honestly, don't be surprised if we cut at this point. Sheesh, what happened? Your mission sucks, and you should feel bad. That's what happened.
Don't use the boost yet. Wait till you got a lot built up.
Oh, I got it. Wait, since you had mentioned it. Yeah, the skill point here is not the crabs. It's record time on the course. I think the crabs, that's probably a trophy you could get.
Maybe. Anyway, skateboarding.
Yeah, I was gonna say, hey, you wanna say something?
Yeah, I was trying to think of what to talk about right now. Like, just a bunch of Reignites that want to skateboard Spyro, and Spyro has, like, a jetboard right now. Like, right out of Back to the Future, mind you.
Yeah, I like the board itself. I just feel like...
there's a picture of Ripto on the bottom of it.
I didn't even notice.
It's one of those blink and miss it moments, though.
I didn't think I'd miss it.
I don't think that's faster than doing it the old-fashioned way.
What, going on that hill?
No, doing the blue star.
How did I get down to fourth? What the hell? How am I in sixth?
Huh? How's that even possible?
What?
What's going on right now?
It says I didn't even finish the lap.
How is that possible?
Excuse me?
Where are the Rhinox? Did the thing glitch?
I don't know, but I'm gonna keep going.
Oh my god, if we had a fucking part glitch right now, man.
I'm gonna keep going, just because this is kind of funny.
This is weird. No, don't go up the top path this time. Go this way. You're not even doing tricks?
I'm confused.
Huh? What?
Are you serious? How is that even possible?
I mean, I know this collection has glitches, but damn, it's...
This is Crash Team Racing levels of fucking bullshit right now.
Honestly, I guess I'm kind of... the only reason I'm okay with this glitch at the moment is because at least it's letting me collect the gems now. Like, it's giving me an opportunity to grab them.
I suppose.
But this is still jarring.
Extremely. Red gem. 9 o'clock. Left gem.
Ah, shit, I fell.
Left gem.
It's not like it matters. They're gonna tell me I lost anyway.
I know. Left path. How did they get in front of you?
I have no idea. I'm so...
jeez, what happened?
Good question!
I'm asking the same thing, Hunter. Okay, so,
Yeah.
Welcome to the glitchy Spyro Reignited Trilogy...
part.
...collection.
How did you still get the boost for that?
They pitied me. The game decided, you know what, we're sorry, about whatever the fuck that was. So, here's some pity.
Well, at least you get some boost. Now you're in first, let's keep it that way.
And let's not glitch it up, game.
You know, this really reminds me...
I got the gems though, that's good.
Yeah, okay. Whoopee. In CTR, Nitro Fuel, in the online stuff, because you know for a fact that every online game, people cheat, right?
Yeah.
Somehow, by some grace of God, it wasn't me that it happened to, But I saw a video of a guy who got first place in an online match against all these really good people. And he was like, oh, I took him to the screen and said, this is the placing. He went from first to eighth. Even after he won the race and the game said he won the race. And didn't get the reward for it.
Hmm.
Because someone hacked the game and put him at eighth and put themselves at first.
Yeah.
I'm just like, how is that possible? How could people do that?
To be honest, I know this is going to sound weird, but I feel like we hadn't... Maybe it's just because I'm forgetting because we haven't done a video in a while. I feel like we haven't even talked about the CTR Nitro Fueled Collection, to be honest.
CTR Nitro Fueled Collection.
Well, it's technically a collection. Because it's not just CTR, it's Nitro Kart and some of tag team racing.
Not even a little tag team racing, honestly. I hate to burst your bath time bubble, though.
Bull?
I meant to say bro. Sorry.
I think I just noticed also, I think the glitch with the lap is because there's a little, like, blade of grass or something.
And?
And I think you have to specifically land on it in order to be credited with a lap.
I do not think that makes any fucking sense.
Hey, this is a glitchy collection.
Unfortunately, this race with Hunter is a little bit different. You have to actually kill all the crabs and beat him, which bothers the fuck out of me.
Wait, was it not like that in the original?
No, it was like that in the original, but even in the original, it bothered the fuck out of me. Because, like, why do I have to kill the crabs and beat you at the same time, you know? Don't do a trick here, just go up there so you can get the crab. See what I mean? Like, it's so...
Fuck, jumped over it.
You get another lap, man.
I know, but still.
Now build up some boosts, because you're going to need it. Can you do anything other than front flips, though? Like,
it,
Jesus.
I like doing front flips because I feel like back flips kill my momentum.
Alright, keep doing it. Or, you know, die!
Ah, shit.
What?
It looked kind of funny, I'll give it that.
Oh yeah, it's fucking hilarious, the glitches in this game. But anyway, if you wanted to talk about CTR Nitro Fueled...
Well, only because I feel like... I feel like we haven't talked about it.
Well, we can talk a lot about it now since all the DLC has been released. For now, at least. I don't think they announced anything else after the Spyro DLC.
If they do, they do. Nah, it's cool.
Yeah. I mean, it's not like I wanted any CTR levels, because, like, realistically... CTR. Crap. That was impressive.
Yay.
It's not like I don't want tag team racing levels, it's just none of the levels in tag team racing are made for the gameplay styles of CTR and Nitro Kart. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't know only because I have very little experience. Oh, for a minute I thought he was going to say, sheesh, why didn't you beat them? Now, what's the course record here?
I don't know, actually. I think it might be 2 minutes, maybe?
Can I do this?
Check it.
Find out. No.
Nope. Looks like you're fucked.
Well, I guess I'll just have to grin and bear it and hope I do the best.
Good luck.
But I was going to say, I only don't know because I feel like I have no experience with tag team racing.
Think of it like this. Tag team racing is much more of a crash platformer than any other crash racing game that came before it.
I feel like I played CTR tag team racing on the PSP.
Yeah, because I owned it for PSP and PS2.
Yeah, I think I remember because being the immature little kid I was, I just remember laughing at...
Yeah, the loading screen where you could make him fart and burp
where you can
and shit.
Burp and all that.
Oof. Bog. Bee. You know that shit.
Yeah. Really, the only crash racing game before, of course, Nitro Fuel, that I had any experience with, and it wasn't that much, was the original CTR.
Because I think I bought CTR off Amazon back in the day.
Yeah. It was, Because
it wasn't on the PlayStation Store.
Yeah, that and Crash Bash, you bought the, not-for-resale versions.
Not-for-resale?
Yeah, because, originally they came in, like, a 3-pack with Warped, but... I guess the person selling them to you had the not-for-resale versions?
I don't know if that makes them rarer or not. I have the game still.
I mean, I don't know. You know.
I mean, I didn't get into CTR because realistically I wasn't a kart racer.
That might be the run.
I wasn't a kart racing kind of person. Hell, I didn't even play Mario Kart at the time.
I wasn't a kart racing person until, like, some of the recent Mario Karts.
And I still don't want people, and as much as people are saying it, I still do not want a remaster of Crash Bash.
Yeah!
Wow! Nice!
Alright. Let's get out of this hellacious level.
No, actually, deadass, I'm really happy about that because, for starters...
I hope it counts.
Yeah, it does.
Oh.
It's at skill point.
Well, no, I mean, like, the exiting the level counts as beating the level up, you know?
They gave me the extra gems.
I know.
But I'm happy because also I had just said earlier we might have to cut because I thought I was going to fail. I'm scared what level you're going to pick because I'm scared I'm going to get stuck with another shitty level.
What other bad levels are there in this world, though?
Actually, I'd say the next worst, because the other ones aren't as bad as that, but I'd say the next worst for me is Fireworks Factory.
You don't like Fireworks Factory?
I like it. I don't like the minigames.
Did I beat the Speedway already? It's been a long time.
Yeah, we did beat the Speedway.
Because
I remember I wanted to do Icy Peak, and I thought you were going to do Lost Fleet, but then you said, I'm doing the Speedway. And you trolled me.
I really wanted to do this level over here. Like
Frozen
so
Altars. Oh, I love Frozen Altars. Oh, fine. You can do it.
Wait, do we even have time? What time are we at?
11.
Wow, really?
If anything, we'll just do what we did last time and cut off at a if you can't finish Cat Hockey.
It doesn't feel like it's been 11 minutes, honestly.
Probably because we were having a good conversation. And also just because I just love my reaction just beating that and getting skill point by 2 seconds. Just...
I mean, one thing I really hate about Nitro Fueled is that they took out the cheat codes, so I actually have to try to unlock the characters this time.
Welcome to Frozen.
Know what I mean?
Yeah.
By the way, I love how this fairy is just a recolored Zoe.
Yeah. I mean, I was going to say my thing is...
This is the only level in the entire series that gives Spyro a different breath, by the way.
Yeah. I was gonna say, like, if I haven't said my thoughts on CTR yet, like in a video, a lot of people found my Metacritic review, not a lot of people, but more people on Metacritic found my review unhelpful than they did helpful. What are you doing?
In the original version, he didn't have our I'm Hurt animation, so I wanted to see it.
Well, the reason why people probably found it unhelpful, I think the game's Metacritic score has gotten a little bit lower because of the controversy with,
microtransactions!
Thank you. And in my review, I didn't call them out for it, but in my defense...
You made the game before they were added.
Way before. I even made a joke in my review about how early I was. Because I usually am never early to reviewing games. Like new games, because I... you know, tend to wait a while before I play them, or I take a while. But that game I beat in one day, so I made a joke where I was like, man, I haven't been this early to review a game since... I haven't been this early to review a game, have I? Like, something like that. But people, I guess, didn't find my review helpful because...
You point out the microtransactions.
And yeah, the reason why I didn't is because, for better and for worse, whenever I write a review on Metacritic, it's a product of... the time that I played and beat it. For example, like, I think there could be a good point against me because, like, I called out Activision for adding microtransactions to Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered, but...
Which, to this day, bothers me because I'm like, how are you adding microtransactions to a single-player-focused game?
Well, there's no player in Modern Warfare.
Yeah, well, what are you going to do, make them buy perks?
I don't know. But the point is... like, if people might think, oh, you call it out in COD but not in Crash, like, is it biased towards a series? No, it's not. Again, it's the product of the time the review was written. I wrote my Modern Warfare Remastered review 3-4 years after the game came out, so, because that's when I played the game. Crash Team Racing Nitro Fueled, I played and beat it, like, within the first few days of release.
And realistically, it's not a hard game.
Yeah, I actually beat it, the story mode, in one day. Obviously...
You obviously didn't go for everything, though.
No shit, but still. The point is, as you said, it's not a... Wow, you really are breaking this. You're doing shit I didn't even know you could do.
What do you mean? You're supposed to do that.
No, I did the whole long platforming thing to do that. I didn't know that was a thing.
I'm sorry, but I have to stop real fast. It's weird playing it on PS4 now because I just got the Switch version, and it's like the Switch version is so much slower.
Yeah, that's how I felt, I don't know why you did that, but...
Just to show it off.
That's how I felt, when we did the Doom Let's Play, because I mentioned it right from the first part. Right when we started the Let's Play, it was right after I beat the Switch version. So seeing it in 60 frames per second, I was just like, God, I'm dizzy.
It really does make you dizzy. And it's weird because I actually have Rumble right now on my hand, so I'm like, oh, okay. Because I'm playing the game in hand.
Wait, did you get the egg?
What's that?
Did you get the egg?
The egg.
The one on the island?
Yeah, I got the egg on the island. His name is Cecil.
Oh.
But I missed the gem over here. So I'm a terrible person.
But yeah, what I was saying with my review is the only reason I didn't call it out in CTR is because I beat the game within 4 hours. When, like, the first day I played it, I beat it. I think I even made a joke on, like, my Snapchat and my Insta story. Like, I posted a picture of the PS4's, like, load screen for it. I was like, ah, hello, beautiful, like, because I was so excited to play it. And then 4 hours later, I just posted, and just like that, I'm already done the game. Huh, how about that?
But you did speed through it, though. Don't let that speak for the length of the game, folks.
Yeah, I was going to say, don't let that speak for it, because the game is definitely beefy, and I think I even mentioned in my review, don't let the fact that I sped through it speak for the quality of the game, the length of the game, because there's a lot to do in it. And also, I was going to say, ironic you said I sped through it, because...
Yeah, it's a racing game, haha.
Car
yeah.
racing. But honestly, I mean, I was a little with the microtransactions, but the game itself, I actually quite like. If in terms of dueling games, I was thinking a lot about, like, for this year, because they were both recognizable platformer franchises and stuff, Team Sonic Racing versus CTR Nitro Fueled.
There's no versus there. Crash Nitro Fueled won.
Yeah, I mean, like, even though I had my problems with Crash Nitro Fueled, I think that that game honestly runs circles around Team Sonic Racing, and I like Team Sonic Racing, but...
I'm sorry, but Team Sonic Racing felt rushed.
I like Team Sonic Racing, but after playing Nitro Fueled, I... honestly could be happy not going back to Team Sonic Racing. Like, I feel like...
going back to it.
Like, I feel like it was something where I kind of forgot Team Sonic Racing existed after Nitro Fueled.
In all honesty, after I played Team Sonic Racing... Well, first off, the game's only, like, $20 right now, I believe.
It's pretty cheap.
I'm like, that makes me think it was made on a budget.
I think
it feels like a budget game.
I think my problem with it is that I think Team Sonic Racing mechanically... is great.
It has a great idea for a kart racer.
My problem with the game as a whole is just that it's bogged down by repetition. And I agree with you that it may have been made on a budget, because I'm not gonna lie. There are, like, the cutscenes for the game.
They're not even cutscenes.
One,
they're
not
images.
They're not mandatory, and two, like you said, they're still images. I'm like, really? Like, this in a Sonic game? And that's a game that, like, you know, there's a lot to do in it, like CTR, but
well,
I feel like...
what you're doing with that game is...
I feel
annoying.
Like, at least from what I've seen from you playing it and from what I've watched, I feel like going for everything in CTR and, like, playing it longer feels more gratifying, whereas Team
Sonic...
Wow! Yeah.
Keep talking about this. This is making me do great.
Whereas Team Sonic Racing, to me, isn't as gratifying if you try to go for a lot of stuff.
I tried going for everything. I just got a headache.
I think the best thing about Team Sonic Racing for me is the fun callbacks that it has to other Sonic games.
And that's about it.
And again, I think mechanically it's a good game. It's just that it's bogged down a lot by repetition.
What's even worse is that unlike CTR, there's very little characters to play as, too.
I'd say, basically, the way I look at it, when I reviewed that game, I gave it like a 6. Now, that's not a disappointing 6, because I wasn't expecting this game to be, like, the bee's knees. If anything, I'd probably say it's a less disappointing game than something like, I don't know, Forces?
Okay, yeah, probably.
Because obviously, it's a smaller scale thing.
Oh, yeah, well, Forces was also an anniversary game, so you have higher expectations for a game that celebrates an anniversary, you know?
Yeah. And, you know, Team Sonic Racing is still a fun game, it's just that, you know, it's got... flaws. It's a decent little thing. If you're a big Sonic fan, I'm sure it's going to be good, but I feel like in the battle of the year's two big kart racers, which would be that and CTR, to me, it's really no contest. CTR runs circles around it.
Like, here's the thing. Like, CTR, yeah, it has a hard mode on it and everything, but you don't have to do the hard mode to unlock everything in the game. And plus, everything in the game is cosmetic, so there's nothing that buffs your stats or anything like that.
Mm.
Team Sonic Racing, I was ready to call it Sonic Team Racing. Team Sonic Racing has randomized loot, alright? Like, randomized gear that you can unlock, it's never the same thing.
Wait, where are you going?
Back up to the top to get the last egg.
Oh, for a minute I was gonna say, wait, you gotta...
I wanted that open so I could get back in without having to run through the entire level again.
Makes sense.
I'm sorry, I lost my place. Like, you get... And
Team Sonic Racing having, like, randomized loot?
Yeah, let's get one thing straight. Both these card games have, like, in-game currency you can get just by playing the games. But unlike Crash, Sonic stuff is all randomized. Like, there is not a way in hell that you can know what you're getting before you get it. And it buffs your stats, and if you get all the gold stuff, you know, gold means great, alright?
Yeah.
Which means if you're playing online, you're kind of beating everybody's ass, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
What's even worse is that if you play the story mode on the hard difficulties, they make you do all this backflip shit just to unlock everything, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Great.
I mean, like, I'd rather get the in-game loot in CTR because at least then I'm just getting cosmetics. I'm not getting anything that's going to make me better or worse, you know?
Yeah. Also, I'm just going to say this. CTR lets you play Spyro.
Well, now it does.
Now, but still.
Well, that's one thing I kind of hated about the CTR DLC because they advertise the characters like Tuana, Baby T-Rex, and Spyro. You don't get them immediately from the DLC. You actually have to play and unlock them.
Well, I mean,
I
guess
I'm
that gives
fine
it,
with that.
I think that gives it good motivation without pulling like an EA with Battlefront 2. It gives you a sense of pride and accomplishment. Like, it's still like guarantees you get them. You still have to like work for them though.
Yeah, and here's the thing. You don't spend the in-game currency to buy them. You actually have this other method of getting the characters. Well, just the Spiral. Just the main characters that come as the face front for
oh,
the DLC.
What the fuck? So do you get the egg?
I don't know.
What the hell kind of spawn point was that?
What is happening in this let's play?
This is definitely a part glitch. So what happened? Do you have to...
Wait, what's the catch?
The ice cats.
It didn't count?
I challenged a Rhinoc to...
Oh, what
the
fuck?
The hell is that shit?
Well, at least we can still talk a little bit.
Yeah, but I'm just so confused.
What is going on right now? Did this version find out I have the Switch version? Are you upset with me, Spyro?
Wait, you know what? You know what? I'm not surprised. I've said this before, but this is... We learned this from our old, like, Sly Cooper Let's Plays and stuff. Stop. Don't you hit my cat out of my goal. I mean, I know I should. That should be you saying it, because I'm not the one.
Oh, he's already in my goal. It counted. Alright.
Because I was going to say this. You know what I just realized? We learned this from the old Sly Collection Let's Play. This is Sanzaru who made the Spyro 3 port. Of course it's going to be fucking glitchy.
Yeah. Alright, I'm not touching anything. I'm not touching anything.
There you go.
Like... Okay, let me finish what I was saying about Nitro Fueled.
Fueled? Not Feud.
In Nitro Fueled, if you do certain tasks, you get, like, this currency, kind of, but, like, it's like fuel. You're fueling up the bar to get the characters and get some more skins and stuff like that. And then you can use in-game currency to buy the rest of the characters that come with the DLC. So I'm like, it makes you play the game instead of paying money to get the character.
Hmm.
Which I'm fine with, because it's, like, traditionally unlocking a character. The only character in this game I'm never unlocking is in Trophy, because I'm not playing all 33 levels of Time Trials.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
And it's even worse because there's no... They took the cheat codes out of this game, so I can't just cheat and put Entropy in it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Now, before we cut...
Ah, yeah. This happens. Stupid Hunter likes to hit the fuck me button, so yeah.
Just...
Alright, folks, we'll see you next time.
See you in the next part. Hopefully it'll be a little less glitchy.